Hello friends, welcome to Wall Street Mojo's investment banking tutorial. Today's topic is the two variable data tables, and I will teach you why it is extremely important from the point of view of valuations. Now think of you performing a valuation exercise, which essentially consists of the discounted cash flows, the free cash flow projections, and then ultimately coming down to the stock price. So as an example here, I have this Alibaba IPO. Discounted cash flow valuations, which you can find this model on this wallstreetmojo.com website. Here what we did was we forecasted the valuations, the free cash flow to the firm, and with the help of these two assumptions like the cost of capital of the business and the infinite growth rates, we found the adjusted equity value of the firm, or the per share value came out to be 78.25. Now let's assume that in this case my assumptions were, let's say, very pessimistic, and you as a client want to look at some optimistic assumptions, which means that, you know, let's say the growth rates, if they change to 4% to infinite, what will be the changes in the valuation of the stock or the fair price of the stock? Or let's say the cost of capital was not 9%, it was, let's say, 8%. What will be the valuation of the stock? So this data table, which is the two-dimensional data table, helps us perform the sensitivity analysis and helps us find the answers, which are very complex in nature otherwise. So there's a way in which this two-dimensional data table is created. It has a very specific format. On one side, you can put one set of variable, which is the cost of capital here, or the weighted average cost of capital. On the other side is the other variable which you want to change, that is this growth rate. So we have these two variables, the WACC, or the cost of capital, and the infinite growth rate, that is the 3%. So we want to see the changes of these two variables and how it affects the share price, right? So as I said, there's a specific way. First, you need to create this table like this. So you can interchange growth rate to WACC and WACC to growth rate, that's all right. Just that you need to make a proper table. Also remember that you can change these numbers too. So it can be 7, 7.5%, 8%, 9.5%, 12.5%, you know. So I would leave it to you to decide what percentages do you want to. But the basic rule which we typically as an analyst followed was to keep the one which we have used, like 9% as cost of capital here, in the middle. And maybe two increments down and two increments up is what is the standard practice. Likewise, you know, for the growth rate, you can do that. 4% or 3% is our basic midpoint. So you can go 2 points up and maybe two, three points below. So that's how you can look at this WACC and the growth rate sensitivity analysis table, right? Now, as a next step, what you need to do is you need to select this whole table, starting from the top, okay? So 78.25 is linked to this cell here. Now then go to data, go to what if analysis, go to data tables. Now here there are two inputs which are required. So this, as compared to the one variable data table, you may remember that in one variable data table only one input is required, but we are doing two variable data tables. This means that we are trying to change two variables at a time. Here, WACC and growth rates. So which is the row input? The row input is the one which is written in the row here. That's the row number 49. So that's the row. Okay. So row input needs to be linked to the original source. Where is the original source? The original source is written here, 9%. Okay. Now, what about the column input? The column input is this one, which is this column D, and where's the original source? The original source is here. Okay, now your work is finished. You just need to press OK. And what you will find is that it populates all the results, which obviously will be very difficult if you have to manually do it, right? So that's why this data table, or the sensitivity analysis using two-dimensional data table, becomes extremely useful for research analysts and investment bankers. Now, how do you validate whether this is right or wrong? You remember, this was the first input, 9% and 3% was the second set of input. See the intersection point? The intersection point is this 78.25. Does this answer matches with the one which you already had earlier? Yes, it does. So this means that your data table is working perfectly fine. Now, another one or two important aspects which you should also remember from this data tables point of view is when you move to this extreme rights or left hand side, you will find the most aggressive or the pessimistic assumptions coming into. Say, for example, the most optimistic assumption would be that cost of capital goes below 7% or it is 7% and the growth rate is 6%. So the valuation of the stock here will be 409.45 per share. Likewise, the most pessimistic case would be 11% as cost of capital and growth rate to be as low as 1%. So we note that the value of the stock is 50.19. So this whole table is a very extremely useful table. It generally goes into the research reports and the investment banking pitch books for the client to understand various different kinds of scenarios that come into play. So hope this video helps. Thank you very much.